when 2015 rolls off, I'll be thinking about 2016 and what we're going to do, and some plans for that. And this will be the 30th, or next year will be the 30th anniversary of the camp. It was established in 1986. We'll roll into 2016.
What time is it here? Yeah, it's 6:17. I just arrived Syntax's house after the drive up from Central Delaware, and loaded all his stuff up in the back here, and he's about to jump in. We'll head to Dunkin' Donuts for a coffee, and then we'll get up the turnpike. Well, part one of the trip, made it up here to Buckhorn. Syntax and I, gonna stop in Panera's over here, grab some breakfast, another coffee, finished up the Dunkin' Donuts, and we're on to step two. And next time you see me, we'll be going up to the cabin. Arrived the 30th year for its go time camp. PA deer season just a scant 3 days away. It is Friday about 11 o'clock again. Syntax and I have made the trip Black Friday. Always great traffic. I know a lot of people are either home or shopping or online shopping. Love making that trip up. The traffic is always light, moves real smooth. About 6 hour ride as usual for me. And we are here. We got the car loaded up. Really good food this year. You're in for some treats as far as that goes. Got some great beer, good whiskey, Eagle Rare. You've seen it before, but it deserved the comeback. It's really good stuff, and we're gonna enjoy it. And you enjoy your Pennsylvania deer season. Always love this. Been going since I was about 17 or 18 or so, probably 17. I think I remember going right after high school, or right while I was in high school, and been going every year since. Been a great time as always. I love getting together with friends. Originally did it with family and friends. Now it's all friends and of course family with Syntax and Sean here. So really enjoy it. Love getting together with everybody. Love the tradition of Pennsylvania deer season. I'm sure if it's not Pennsylvania, whether it's Wisconsin or Maine or Michigan or Ohio, Indiana, anywhere, Louisiana, somewhere down south, Florida, it doesn't matter where, you enjoy your deer season just as much as we enjoy our seasons here.
Hey, welcome, welcome.
Hello, man. What's up? How you doing?
Good.
9:30 I left, so
four on the dot.
I left at 5, I got here at 11, mine was 6.
Did it rain at all when you guys were coming up?
A couple of just a mist.
I just felt a drop, actually.
Oh, shit.
This 27 inch shit.
Wow, 40 inch.
Around
things are coming around.
All right. You know?
Yep. Combo, DVD combo. Yep. I hope it's Blu-ray.
No. Yeah, come on. That's all right. Our collection is DVDs, so now we don't have to upgrade.
Here's our 27-inch TV. It is on a nice folding, what do they call these? The racks, the mounts. So it's going to have to come out, and we'll go ahead and we all chipped in some money and bought the 40-inch. So we'll go ahead and take this guy down. Let's get the big one up.
All 10 of Wellsboro's finest.
Yeah.
Well, they're not from Wellsboro, but they're achievable from Wellsboro. Mostly New York stations, right?
Yeah, I think so. I think some might be out of Williamsport.
Hey, boys. Welcome.
Hello, man.
What's up?
How you been?
Good, how are you?
Pretty good.
Our beer selection for the trip. Official White Rook beer, I think, of Camp Go Time. Dogfish Head Ales. Now, it's a brewery that is only about 35 miles from my house. What we have here, the box, Pennsylvania Tuxedo. Pennsylvania Tuxedo is a little bit of a shout out or an homage to the Pennsylvania hunters right where we are, north central PA. They used to be dressed up in the black and red. I know somebody that knows how to dress right.
Now you gotta put this on.
Exactly. You know, what am I doing in OD green? This is ridiculous. Hold on. This is right. This is exactly right. This is how we should be dressed.
Styling.
Again, Dogfish Head. If you've never tried it, I know it's going national. You know, I've seen this when I've been visiting out in Wisconsin and other places. I know you can get it. If you haven't tried it before, definitely give it a go. I'm highly recommending it. Not because it's local to my area, but just because it's great beer. If you know anything about the gentleman that runs it, Sam Caligione, great guy, great, just an ambassador for good beer. And you may have seen him, I think if you've ever watched the Doc Beer Incorporated or Beer USA, whatever it is, he's in that. And he just has a passion for beer. Pennsylvania Tuxedo, again, collaboration between Woolrich and Dogfish Head. Woolrich, of course, doing the black and red outfits since well from the 1800s. But Dogfish doesn't do a variety pack like we're used to doing. So I made my own. Our Pennsylvania Tuxedo. Look at this guy. You don't have that next time. Next time, and the pants, but we'll get there. This is a good beer, 8.5% alcohol, and again we're going to have to be watching it a little bit. And this is their 60-minute IPA. This is the bread and butter for Dogfish.
Standard.
This is really good. If you had the 90 or the 120 IPA, and again really 60 minutes, brewed, 60 minutes continual hops, and again, for the 90 and the 120, really good stuff, 6%. We're going to get some of this on ice. We're going to really enjoy this beer.
The one time you say something about it, you don't
do it. Mm-hmm. Well, it's okay with me, because
yeah,
every time
whatever.
I've done it, it's always been right anyway.
Up there and there's like green peppers on one of them, it's like whatever.
Yeah. What are we gonna do? Drive all the way back? You okay getting that?
Yeah.
Time for some Pennsylvania Tuxedo made with spruce tips. We're gonna enjoy some. We got the pizza. There we go. Not too bad. I think it's going to be pretty good for cooking out here.
The light, yeah.
Yeah. Let's get some pizzas. These beers. Breakfast time. Pork roll. That's a breakfast. Everything bagels, pork roll, cheese, and coffee, of course. A couple cups of that. Need that this morning.
Oh, look at that. Nice color on that.
We'll give Eric the double cheese.
The double cheese.
Watch out.
Yeah, from right on top. There you go.
Turn this up a little bit. Add some cheese.
Well, here it is Saturday morning. You can see a little bit of snow in the background. Had some snow showers last night. For some reason, I had to get up a couple times in the middle of the night and went out there, and it was really coming down. A little bit of mix and rain. About 33 degrees this morning. And we're supposed to have partly cloudy or cloudy weather. High about 40-ish. For the day, we're gonna head down into the woods, check our stands. Camp Cook's got to get his doghouse blind set up, and Medicine Man's gonna make sure that everything's set over at his stand in the woods, his apartment building over there, and we know he's gonna be fine. Finished up Delaware deer season this week, or just last week, and it was a good season for me. I got this nice buck.
Just put one down over there. Gonna have to get down out of the stand, take a look. Pretty nice. Not giant, not small. Just over to him now. Savage 220, 20 gauge slug gun. And let's take a quick look. There he is. Pretty nice Delaware 6-pointer. If you stretch it, you can get an 8 out of it, but more like a 6, big 6.
I think it was about a Thursday. Seemed to be a little rutting activity. It was moving at 2:45 in the afternoon, went right past my stand. I put a good shot on him and knocked him down. Really good buck, really happy about that. Got a lot of meat out of him in the freezer right now, and the head's going to the taxidermist for a mount. He's going to be on my wall, and I'm going to appreciate him for the rest of my days. If you missed our November update, Medicine Man and myself were up here, and he tagged out on an antlerless deer with a bow. So we got one this year. We're hoping to get more. We know there's some good deer here. 1 8-point, 2 6-points that we've been seeing on the camera for most of the summer fall. So we're hoping they're going to be around.
Yeah, there's a hill behind him, so I'm almost level with him. But he is up there a good 15 feet or so. I'll check out everything, make sure all the boards are secure, anything he leans on, and always want to do that. You never want to just assume that everything's going to be fine after a year. You know, he's got his brush, going to get all those leaves out of there. And there they go. All that stuff you definitely don't want to be doing on Monday morning. Make enough noise going into the woods with your light and crunching leaves, and doing this would be added. So you want to take care of all that stuff too.
Yeah, something else I did early November. Put the roof on with the wrap around the bottom of the stand, and then put that material between the roof and the shooting ground. Cut slits in there and then pulled it in with some pipe cleaners. So it's going to be pretty concealed up there. I'm going to hop up in there now, make sure everything's okay again. Pretty concealed in here. Seat level, about right here. You're going to have a hard time picking me out. Well, this is what we're hoping they come up and eat. Fairly good acorn crop, not as good as it was a couple years ago, but we're gonna hope that they're gonna be in here. Got a couple big oak trees, you know, on the property, you know, mature oaks. So hopefully the corn is down the bottom, and the deer will be up here foraging on their natural food, acorns and browse.
What's up, Thomas?
Hey. Peace, dog.
Peace.
You know, just being nice and quiet up until now.
Fuck it, dude. Some other asshole's gonna be making noise galore tomorrow. We might as well be us. Right now.
What the hell is that on your head?
Dresses are fucking
yarmulke.
Look like you're going to the gym.
I don't go to the gym. I need to do work. I ain't gonna. That should have been taken care of.
You didn't put in the work order.
Yeah, no work
order. I put in the work order yesterday, and I'm already not liking our new relationship. So
I don't think you're set
a little to the right.
Yeah.
Stop. Safety first. You gotta hold on, Mike.
Come on, work it. Work it. Beverages to consume, rib roast to eat.
After I'm off the ladder, of course.
Yeah.
Safety first.
Oh, of course. And we haven't even started that yet.
Wait till 10 a.m.
Now it's after 10. Or it's 5:30 somewhere. Either we're 4:30, whatever it is.
It's cabin time somewhere.
Take a couple minutes just to thank all the people and wish them good luck also that have sent me messages saying good luck, and they like the channel, they like the videos, and like I said, good luck in the hunting season. So I really want to send that back to all the people that have watched the videos and commented, and I appreciate the feedback and the positive wishes that you give us, so I'm certainly going to give those back to you. I wanted to mention too the gentleman I met up at the Wawa up in on 80 and the Turnpike on the November trip, early November. I'm sorry I didn't ask for your name. I know you said you were going to work on the bear-proof deer feeder that we did, and good luck with that. Again, sorry I didn't get your name, but it was nice meeting you up there and just you recognizing me. You don't know how you made my weekend. Check out a YouTube channel if you guys like, especially if you're a pipe smoker. I've become one in the last 6 months or so. But Backcountry Pipe. Mark has a real nice channel there. He's up in Nova Scotia. He does some great videos on deer hunting and hunting in general and wildlife and pipes. Pipes and cigars, if you're into that. Check out Mark's channel. Again, Backcountry Pipe. He sent me this hat, and again, it is the Big Game Society of Nova Scotia, and Mark, I appreciate that, and I really want to send a shout out to you, just thanking you for that. The background is the cabin, and 30 years, again, the 30 years of the camp, senior, basically, and you probably noticed he's not with us any longer. Unfortunately, we lost him a few years ago, and another guy that was in the camp, we kind of named Bub, was his nickname. His name was Joe, but his nickname was Bub, or he called us Bub, and we called him Bub back. We lost those two guys over the years. We certainly miss those two guys. But Senior, really, he was the one that started this. and we put the cabin up. The cabin looked a little bit different. It wasn't quite as fancy, but he really got this started and did all the work on the inside, and he was quite a good friend of mine, and again, I miss him. But we're all grateful to Senior for what he really started up here. I'll tell you what, let's take a little bit of walk down memory lane and check out what the cabin used to look like.
And here's the cabin, original roof, no front porch, no deck in the front. The inside kind of looked dull and gray. There's starting to improvement, had the old ceiling in there. And our old wood stove, I pumped out some heat. And one other wood stove, it didn't work too well. And then the front deck went on. That was a nice addition. And here's the side. You could still see the old deck. Then it's time for the new roof. Senior's favorite color, red. So it started going on. There he is, putting all the screws into the roof and finished it up. Great job we did. And Senior also built a shed we have out there. And it was time for a front patio. And a new back deck also. There he is, painting it up, doing a good job. And just about finished there. Still needed the railings. And then we cleared some land in the back. Gives those nice fields that we have out there now. Looks great.
Well, that was certainly an interesting look of how things changed. You know, the cabin 20 by 24, that hasn't changed. The inside originally, again, just the wood studs, and it's grown to what it is now. It's a real home away from home feeling. Of course, we don't have the running water, we don't have the electricity, but it is home away from home. And the chairman, and that was Senior's son, the chairman of the board, Mike, and his basically childhood friend, Steve, or camp cook, and college buddy would be Eric, medical man, and of course myself. I was a good friend of Senior for many, many years, and started really hunting with him in about 85, I think, and hunted with him every year since. And of course, Sean Syntex, my son, and I really enjoy his company up here. I really like spending time with him, the rides up him, and the conversations that we get to have. It's really a nice time that we get to spend together.
Gutter's officially done.
Nice work. Nice
you're
work.
Done. Yeah. And you're what, 10 minutes before the game
Ten
starts?
10 minutes.
And there's cheesesteaks twerking. I know. You showed
Life
up,
is good,
showed up at the right time.
I came at the right time.
Bring the Philly to the cabin there, Steve. Hey. Pork roll for breakfast, cheesesteak for lunch.
It looks pretty good.
Flavoring in it.
It looks pretty solid. Make what?
Chicken too.
Oh yeah.
Shaved chickens. You make chicken cheesesteaks.
I like chicken cheesesteaks.
Yeah, I was gonna make. I wasn't sure what to bring this time.
Oh, that is good. Oh boy, look at these. Lunchtime, cheesesteaks, half pound each.
Yep.
Their kitchen and their bed is in the fucking kitchen.
Is there laundry in the
Look at the floor. Look at the fucking floor.
I only want to see if there's laundry in the background.
There, laundry in the front round.
There it is.
There it is. In the front.
All right. That's pretty amateur.
Yeah, that's great. Oh, here's a great thing. Look at all the debris and shit in the background of our house. And someone's taking a dog. Look at its big trash. What? Dude, oh there's God. The kitchen. There's the mattress.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Like, what are you eating?
Hey, baby, what you eating?
What's up, though?
Hey. What you eating, girl? All
right, hold on.
What's up, there? A little shrimp cocktail appetizer tonight. Camp cook special. There's butter on this 5.5 pound roast.
Got every time in the thing, I'm
having garlic.
Jesse James is still playing?
Still, he's only like his second year. First of all, he played for a while.
Well, we're up to about 500 on the grill. And we have our roast. And he is ready. I'm gonna put some beef broth in there. I want to keep this nice and moist. All right, we've been hovering about 500 now for about 30 minutes. Let's take a quick look. Yeah, look at that. That is looking good. About what we want to see. Got some onions, carrots, and nice lumps of garlic. That's going in the al jus along with all this butter that's melted off of this. Temperature probe reading 55 right now. I'm gonna go ahead and stick this in. One other little ingredient to go in an al jus. A little bit of Dogfish Head 60-minute IPA. Not a lot. Not a lot, because a couple guys don't really like the heavy IPAs. But I'm just gonna put, I don't know, what did I put in there? About 3 ounces, maybe less. Just to give it a little character. Let me get those potatoes ready too.
Oh yeah.
Oh boy. Sure is looking good though. We've been waiting for this for quite some time. Almost as long as we've been waiting for that roast. I think at this point we're...
It's pretty good.
It's looking, yeah. I was gonna say, I don't think it's gonna look any better than that. So we're gonna take it off, let it rest for a few. Have the sauce, the au jus sauce, sitting there simmering. Potatoes are... They feel right. I could slide it over.
Yeah, you certainly could.
I'll just put that one on the low.
Alright.
Let's close this off.
Whoa! Oh boy.
Oh, I got it.
Smells amazing.
Oh. Hold on, let me get this to the top.
Yeah, I need to do that myself.
Yeah. That's a fork.
That is a fork. I don't know how to hold it. Certainly juicy enough.
Oh yeah, that's good to me.
I just want to end, Thomas.
All right, we'll get you next.
Talking about steak or...
Steak.
Or Steve.
There's a couple of garlics on that one.
A little bit.
Is there a fucking Jimmy John's around here? You got a Baja Fresh nearby? What the fuck?
Well, the guys went into town to the Wellsboro Diner this morning for some breakfast. Just didn't feel like making the trip down there this morning. No reason, just wanted to stay back. I gotta have something ready and waiting for them when they do. But a nice night last night, had the great dinner and watched a little TV and movies and the normal, little beverages, etc. As we kind of were going to bed, we saw this little bit of white stuff in the background here. Very, very light snow. It's about 32 degrees, 33 this morning. And nice little coating of snow. But going up into the, I think in the lower 40s today. So this will probably melt. And then getting chilly tonight. So we're hoping at least there'll be some crunching in the morning. We can hear some deer moving around. I'm just going to wait for a text for them and then start the dessert for them. The guys are heading back up from breakfast. Time to put on some Cinnabon cinnamon rolls. All right, let's get these on the grill. What's going on over here?
Just making sure I've got everything in order for the ribs in a little bit. Make sure nothing's been
ribs
frozen.
How are you going to cook
baby back ribs?
You're probably putting the ribs on the gas,
yeah,
I'm assuming.
You're putting the ribs on the grill?
Yeah, I'm the new smoker.
what smoker? Is that what's under that thing?
That's what's under there.
You're kidding. What kind is it?
Smoke Hollow.
Smoke Hollow smoker? We got a smoker up here now?
We do.
Yeah, the inside of my truck smells good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Percolating? Or marinating, I should say.
Oh, boy.
Pretty good. Huh?
Mikey likey. Tom, are you putting any of that cream on them?
Oh, yeah. Icing?
Well, I like cream.
Well, cream. Yeah.
I like cream all over, Tom. My face, my buttocks.
Let's check out the action on this side of the deck.
Oh, nice.
There's the hang stuff.
Yeah.
It just keeps getting better and better up here. I already said this yesterday, home away from home. They are getting a little brown on the top. You think we ought to leave them? I think we ought to leave them another minute.
It's not like it's not like the bottom is getting overdone.
All right. Another couple minutes. I don't know if I spin this around.
Because they're getting color back here. Look at that.
Yeah. And then give another. Ooh, it's hot.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're ready to go now.
With the risk of increasing afternoon clouds, the high near 50. Both Tuesday and Wednesday are very mild, with rain showers moving in both days, the high 57. But both Saturday and Sunday next weekend, and some of the elevations will reach.
Take a leg! Oh, I tried it. In front of me.
An inch off one side and splitting it?
He's doing kindling.
I mean, you could do it in slow mo and play like romantic comedy music.
God.
Oh, wow.
Are you not entertained?
As this keeps going up, no matter what, there'll be a difference. But
now we're starting to get smoke coming out.
Yeah, it has to, about 200 degrees is usually when it'll start to.
What temp are you trying to keep it at, Eric?
Between 225 and 240, to be precise.
Yeah.
Nice.
I got a couple shots before too.
Yeah.
And I got one where I got the.
Hey, you're in it right now.
Oh, nice. I got one where I got the temp gauge, but it's Steve's face over here reflected in it talking about it. Very artistic.
Oh, boy.
You're going to love it.
So the wood chips are finished, but the smoke flavor has already been infused.
Yep.
Oh,
and the that bone. Smoke tube's still going too.
Yep. And what kind of
apple juice?
No, not seasoning did you use for these guys?
Bad Byron's butt rub.
Oh, Bad Byron's butt rub. Okay.
Personal favorite.
And what is that? Is it like a sweet, salty kind of combo?
I would say more on the.
Is it hot?
Spice.
Spicy?
Yeah, not too bad. Kind of a mild spice.
A little gas fill up?
Yeah, gas fill up.
We seem to be going through gas a little faster than previous years.
I think that generator is a little bit more thirsty than our old ones.
You mean it runs all day?
And it runs all day.
Oh, but compared to the blue one, it eats the gas just a little more.
Yeah. You take the Dogfish Brewery Tour, you get one of these to put on your car.
Nice.
All American, red, white, and blue. The blue gloves come out. You know good things happen when the blue gloves come out. Or bad things in this camp. Oh, man. You want me to hold anything?
Nah, you're good.
What is that, juice? Apple juice? Juicy juice.
Fruit punch, actually.
Yeah. You certainly look like you've done this before.
Yeah. Yeah, just a few times.
You want me to open it?
It's alright, this whole thing's gonna get a good mess, but.
No, somebody else shooting in the mountain. I don't know if everybody noticed that we actually have our rifles sighted in already before we came up. So we're no shooting this time. We'll see if it makes a difference. But they, as I've mentioned in other videos, they're certainly shooting still all over the mountain. So apple juice, honey. And brown sugar is what you're putting them on?
Yep.
And then the next is wrapping it thin foil?
Yeah, exactly, for 2 hours. Better.
All right, so you're just wrapping up the tin pan?
Yep.
And back it goes.
That's it for 2 hours, no more messing with it.
Okay.
Man, I go for a beer. Man, I go for a beer. Beer. Beer.
Oh yeah, look at this. Boy, did this arrive. Just in time. Thank you! Thank you!
All right, so I'm gonna take these out, take off the lids. It's gonna be all hot and steamy. I'll just flip 2 racks in here, glaze them, put them back in, and then repeat the process with the second.
Beautiful.
Second.
What's in the glaze?
What's that?
It's like barbecue sauce.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Like honey. What kind of sauce are you
using? Yeah, right there, actually.
Sweet and spicy.
He likes the sweet and spicy. Pull them back from the bone even a little bit more.
Just my little bend test.
Go back in
yeah,
on the racks plane or with yeah. Stay?
Yeah, out. So we want the sauce to caramelize.
Yep.
Yeah.
down. I think we're going to have to start a Tioga chapter of barbecue pit boys.
Okay. That's the barbecue pit boys right there. Oh, and there they are. Finished after, what time did you start these? Noon?
Yeah, 12:30.
12:30 is now about 6:15-ish. Beautiful. Nice job. Bit more brush, huh?
All right. This rack's ready to go in.
Right. Just wait on the potatoes, we'll take our train over. Oh, yeah. Aha! Nice. Oh, ribs are out?
Yeah, this is me and Steve's.
All right. Looking pretty good.
Yeah, we are.
Bam! Nice. Bam! Ah, that smells good. Nice big potato action. Plastic knife is working much better.
So I'm leaving that just like that. Oh, yeah. Booyaka con. All right.
Hiding back there.
It was
Sunday night. It's here. We're all set. Just kicking back and a little football and waiting for 5 o'clock.
Where's Buttercup at?
He'll be up.
Oh, Buttercup. Be afraid to turn that to high.
All
right. That should have been done.
Oh, he's pussies.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Goldilocks, put your head on it.
Yeah.
Damn, they're going to paint that bunny out, you know. Let's snug this.
Damn.
That might be the last year for that outfit right there, Thomas. What? Look at that motherfucker right there.
Yeah.
I'm going on a diet.
Don't try it. Check that ass.
A weight management program.
Yeah, you can go straight cotton when you have a heater at your feet. You guys can both wear moccasins.
Don't try it.
Ew! Steve, at least put something else on.
You can stand it?
Yeah. It's about 6'4" is the ceiling height. But so that I don't give myself away, I usually just stand up and I bend over and just touch my toes. My hips are a window level.
I'll call you when I come it over. I'd like to see that.
Grab my ankles.
I'd like to see that.
You just wait for me to die anyway.
I'm not.
What gave it away? The pillow over your face?
What gave it away? The conversation you heard? What do you think we should do? Pinch his nose?
Is that enough for thermoses and cup?
Get one star with one cup. Let's do it from there. Let's see. This brick horse be set.
Set in motion.
Throwback to the old
man here, Tom, with styrofoam.
No.
Oh,
I didn't know
which
one.
Oh, that's good. You know what? Whatever. Recycle.
Cans and bottles. We're a green camp now.
What?
We're a green camp now.
Oh my god.
Put this bottle right here.
Right? Yep, yeah, I did it. Yeah, you guys don't want to talk to me about the recycling that thing.
You weren't here when we set up a recycling can, so you didn't know about it.
Right. He's only been here 3 days though.
Oh, yeah. Stood next to it 15 times to make a mess, but.
Yeah, man. Drank it. There's a trash can out there. We're bagging it. All the cans and bottles, cans and plastic.
You know the one you're gonna be taking home in your truck tonight?
I don't think so. What's the green light for? So you look like the Hulk walking down.
What?
You look like the Hulk when you're walking down.
The green light?
Yeah.
The green is not scared of deer.
Well,
don't worry, my wife would will.
Oh yeah, I would.
Yeah.
Eric and I can't wait to get in our stand so we can watch you come down.
The light show.
I'm going to turn
northern
around.
Lights.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
The northern light show. That
oh my God, Eric. 31, pal. 31 over here.
It's cold.
That should have been a high before the big five. Just saying.
Yeah, but you think pumping out a lot of heat over here.
Yeah.
In 10 minutes. I'm not sticking around to be cold here.
What you have to look at? I'm looking at
it. I go out and get changed
to the legs.
Yeah, go back
morning.
In.
That's good.
Yeah,
that's good. That's good stuff.
Hey, Eric. Good luck today.
Thank you
be
very
safe
much.
Down there.
You do the same.
Let us know how you make out.
I will.
All right, let me get this light out of your face now. There we go.
Hi, Stefan.
All right.
Catch up to him. Look how nervous.
There's Cook. We're leaving.
Later, Cook.
See you later, Cook. Good luck.
I'll catch him when I scream and yell.
All right. See you later. There he goes. Off to see nothing for the rest of the day.
It's a little tighter, Tommy. It's a little tighter every year.
All right. So all good. All prepared.
So
as you'll ever be, you're going to be warm as hell.
Oh, God, yeah.
The one good thing about those pants, you could take them off if you felt.
Yeah.
And you got the pants underneath. So be all, by the afternoon, I think that's all you're going to need.
Yeah. Sounds like it.
Come on, we're pushing it.
I'm ready.
You ready?
Yeah. I don't need the set of the tire. I mean, I like it. Don't
yeah,
get you're wrong.
Don't, yeah.
All right.
All right.
Shit on it.
Come on in and rub it out.
All right. I'm rubbing. Thomas?
Good luck.
Shawner?
Good luck.
Good luck, buddy.
Good luck, everybody. Be safe.
Know what you're shooting at, Tom.
Will do.
Know what you're shooting at.
Inside my stand. Hopefully we'll have a good day today. It's a cool morning. Not too cold, but would have been
nicer if there was some snow, some crisp leaves on the ground, but we shall see how it goes.
End of the first morning for me. Stayed in about 3 hours or so. And the rest of the guys are gonna do the full day. It takes a lot out of you, but they can do it. Saw some this morning. Saw a batch of two does with two fawns each, group of six moving through. And then we had somebody shoot off the property, but it looks like it scared a buck and four does past the chairman down there, but he never really could identify them or get his rifle up on them. I guess he did see the antlers through the woods, but couldn't get a shot. So I'm hoping I'm gonna head back in, have a little coffee, a little soup, let my back relax. You younger guys appreciate the time that you get to have in that woods at full time. When you start getting a little bit older, it just gets a little bit tougher to do. It's not like I'm complaining. Hopefully it didn't sound like that. So I'll head in, get a little warmed up, have something to eat, and then I'll head out for the afternoon hunt.
It's about 20 after 9. I have seen nothing. Some of the text messages coming back and forth. The other guys have seen half a dozen doe or so. I think Mike also saw a buck, but I think it was in the distance and it was gone before he could get a better look. Looks like in the spring I got a 100-yard shooting lane or two or three to clear every year. You put together a wish list and I'm already thinking of a few other things to do this spring. Shoot more and more shooting lanes and further out is I think number one on the priority list for right now, so hopefully we'll have a little bit more luck and start to see something soon. A dozen or so gunshots I think I've heard so far in the surrounding area, nothing super close, but so I think some guys are having some success, just not right immediately here.
It's getting on about 4:30, first day. It's been quiet since this morning, since deer we've seen. We've had a few go through past Medical Man and Camp Cook down there, but fairly quiet, a few shots here or there. So we're kind of winding down for this day, maybe looking at some rain tomorrow, but yeah, that's how it goes sometimes. Got a good dinner of pork sandwiches waiting for us tonight. So I'll be quiet and take the rest of this about 45 minutes we have left. See if anything will come by to any one of us.
Ribs.
I didn't know if that many wasn't hanging around. I'll pull them out of the fridge if that's the case. But
I was going to say, I was hoping we'd get them for leftovers for tomorrow night.
It's supposed to be only a low of 41 tonight.
Just never felt like it.
Yeah, it's fucking pretty cold.
get home at 2 in the morning, though.
Why not?
Yeah. Because I got to work tomorrow.
Yeah.
It's
7
o'clock in the morning.
What's up,
kid?
What's up?
Thanks for coming. Nice one's in, huh?
What's up,
Steve? Yeah,
for the
I like it.
Taking it to the max.
For the slay.
I like it.
Eric out there?
What's
up?
I see his green. He's somewhere.
What's up? What's up? What'd you see? Just one?
Yeah, barely. Barely saw one. So far away.
Did you get my selfie? I saw it. I've never seen a selfie. Yeah. Check out the fucking selfie. I better make the cut.
Well, you better send it to me in an email.
Oh.
What, would you like that in JPEG?
JPEG. PNG. Huh? Nice PNG file.
Yeah, PNG. There you go.
Ping?
Ping!
Video friendly underpress. Tom, just take that pork out. Sweet.
Don't forget about that pork roll that's down in there.
Oh, yeah.
So. Call.
Good just call. A little.
Exhausted. Thanks. And you can leave it. It's clean lube protection. It's not like something you got to wipe off. You know, you put a seat on there, and yeah, there you go. No Deweys?
Nothing.
ARD program.
Never been pulled over in the state of Delaware.
What state?
You didn't even have to drop Gary's name.
No.
Why would you drop Eric's name?
I said Gary's my next door neighbor.
Gary
here.
Really Italian roast pork.
Italian roast
pork. Pulled, but it's Italian, not, this is not barbecue.
Not barbecue, okay. And we got, what kind of cheese do you have in there?
Extra sharp provolone.
All right. And the rolls?
And some Lissios, some seeded rolls, and some,
I had a feeling there's going to be Lissios.
That's right, some seeded and some round.
What are you going to do with the cheese?
I don't know, I'm just holding it.
I'm
just
going to put it on so it melts a little
bit. I'm sous chef, I just follow orders.
Okay. I was just asking. I'm not saying you're wrong in doing it. I was just asking.
I just figured I'd put a little bit on the rolls, let it melt in a little
bit. Yeah, nothing wrong with that.
If you think he's on the wrong path, don't be afraid to say it.
Yeah. No, I'm not gay. This is his show. I'm not going to mess his show up.
The rolls.
He didn't mess my show up. I'm not going to mess his show up.
A little bit of a pre-melt some cheese, and then people want more. They can always put more. This is made with Sam Adams Winter Lager, some garlic, some poultry seasoning, just some basil, some thyme, some parsley, and more garlic.
Mmm, yum yum.
So, and when I cook it, I put a couple long hots at the bottom, slice them open, so it gives it just a little bit of the flavor of the pepper, a little bit of spice.
You want to see the chairman?
Yep. Has that guy got his own chow?
Oh.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Damn! A little cider! I didn't get that. No, oh. Thomas?
Okay.
Good to see you.
Easy.
Yep. I'll be in touch.
Okay. All right. Hey, take it easy. Eric going out second day in the mist and rain. Going down to the old blind.
Yep.
All right, we'll see you at 7:15 with that buck.
All right, I hope so. Serious? Now you're ready to hunt.
Put a good one on it. I can hear that blowing. Second morning, cold, rainy, windy, not much activity this morning. I just saw a grouse, that was it. Got medical man and Syntex in their stands. The chairman had to go home last night, and camp cook is staying in the cabin for now until it stops raining. We'll keep plugging along here. And see what we can see. I haven't heard much action this morning at all on the mountain, no shooting. So this rain's supposed to stop about 9.
Tuesday afternoon, a little clean and pack. Our camp cook, medicine man. Gonna have to make that trek back down to lower PA. Driving down, or back Route 80, back down to Delaware again. Another great season with the guys. Unfortunately, not successful. Chairman left Monday, and the other guys left yesterday afternoon. Syntex and I stayed yesterday. It was nice. We both saw some turkeys flying up to the roost at the end of the day right near our stands. So that made for something good to watch in the afternoon. If we didn't see any deer, always nice to see some turkeys doing what they were doing and flying up in there, and kind of surprised us how high up in the trees they were. So it was interesting because it was both our stands and we're probably about 400 yards apart, and they were just having to pick the trees right near us. So that was pretty interesting. A great time as always, sharing some time with friends and family. No deer, that's the way it goes. There was one taken two lots away from us, not that far. I think it was the eight pointer that we had on camera was taken. And again, it's, you know, last year was on one side, this year was on the other side, and one of these times it's gotta be on our side here. Hopefully that'll happen soon. Again, great time. If you like the video, hit the like button or subscribe. Follow Syntex and I along on Twitter if you want. Both have our own accounts. I know we don't post a whole lot of unnecessary stuff out there, so if you want to join along, sub to the channels. So until the next video, or until you see Syntex and I in the car heading up for our spring camp video, and we have some things lined up, not a whole lot, not a lot of big projects this year, but join us there. So this is White Rook 85.
Syntex 77.
That's right, Syntex 77. And we'll catch you next time.